and welcome everyone to this 2023 UCI BMX Freestyle Park World Cup stop here in beautiful Bajung. We're getting ready for the men's finale, the final contest of this weekend. And keep in mind, this is the last stop of that BMX Freestyle World Cup. So we're here in China. We got this beautiful city of Bajung where we're at. Now we got the Olympics coming up. So like there's still a lot at stake, a lot of points to be won to claim that spot into the finals. And we'll be guiding you through all the action that is going down today. I'll be your event host, Aegon, and I'm being joined by lovely Dustin.
Yo, what's up? Thank you, Aegon. Such a blessing to be here. So excited to watch this all unfold this afternoon. It's already been unreal, and I can't even begin to describe what we're going to get to witness here for this finals.
So we just witnessed and finished the women's finals, where we had that top spot taken by Dong Yalwen. Second spot went to Hannah, and the bronze medal went to Sun Subai. And that changed up some stuff in the World Cup ranking as well. Hannah took first, and then we saw Sun jumping over to the second spot. Now we're going to take a look at that park. Dustin, what can you tell about a park?
Yeah, this Hurricane Park is unreal. This box jump, that's where you're going to be seeing some of the biggest tricks go down. And right here we have the step-up box jump with the volcano on the side of it that goes into the elevated portion of the course, which then leads itself into the different features there. And right here we're looking at the curve wall. This thing is massive, and the athletes are ripping around it, generating that speed for the box jump. And here we're looking at the TSG hip. You're going to see a lot of different transfers, a lot of unique lines to be able to go down on this feature, as it's a massive hip, and the way that they can go from the box jump all the way over to it is awesome.
Like going side to side in every which way possible. Hurricane Parks did a great job here. I want to thank Feast as well for putting up this fourth and final stop here in Bajung. We're going to be taking you through the format as well. Since this is a finale, Dustin, what can you tell about finales in BMX?
For the competition format, we are now narrowed down to 12 riders, and there's going to be two heats of six riders. Two runs, 60 seconds per rider, and the best run is going to count.
I mean, with that much at stake, there's going to be lots of things taken into account. I mean, if we're looking at the judging that is being performed by some of the top judges that we have. Now, what are they going to take into account, Dustin?
Yeah, let's look at this criteria. The rider score is going to be based on the overall impression of these 10 criteria. The first is difficulty of tricks that the athletes throw down, the height, their amplitude, the regionality and versatility of their tricks, their flow around the course, their own personal style they bring, the variety of tricks that they incorporate, risk factors, how they land on all the different features, their use of the entire course, and their overall execution.
Thank you for that, Dustin. Let's take a look at that judging panel. On the right, we have David Hank-Cleworth. Left of him, it's Bibi Noiro. Then we have Igor Poki, Vukadinovic, Christy Hughes, Luka Kolovic, and the Australian Dave Dillaward. So that is a decked out judging panel.
Absolutely.
Now we're having another look here at the park. We're having the riders lined up.
We're going to take a look at some of the semifinal highlights right here. It has already been an incredible weekend, as I was saying, and we get to see double backflips already going down in this event.
Riders have been using every nook and cranny, every obstacle that this park has to offer. We've seen crazy step-up combos using the whole hip and jump box island, the wall ride. It's been insane. Now we're gonna go back to the course because Catfish is gonna introduce you to all the riders.
For these gentlemen, but we have made it to the finals here in Bajung for the UCI BMX Park Freestyle World Cup. After today's competition, we will have ourselves a world champion in the BMX Cup. So let's get right into it, shall we? First off, we want to thank everybody here in Bajung. We are in beautiful Guangwu Mountain. Perfect setting for a perfect BMX contest. Let's meet our competitors, shall we? Representing Team USA Cycling, Daniel Sandoval!
Daniel currently in that 15th spot in the World Cup ranking.
Representing Venezuela, Daniel Dares!
Your current silver medalist from the Tokyo Olympics and currently sitting in 28th in the overall.
Riding for Team Japan, Rimu Nakamura!
2022 world champion Rimu Nakamura.
Representing Croatia, Marin Rantes!
Marin currently sitting in 20th
riding
in the overall.
Riding for Team Brazil, Gustavo Batista de Oliveira!
Gustavo in that 14th spot in the World Cup ranking.
Riding for Team USA Cycling, Brian Fox!
Brian doing it for Pat right there, and he's currently in 13th in the overall.
Representing Team USA, Marcus Christopher!
And this is an interesting one because he got that second spot in the World Cup ranking, so that's going to be a tough
representing
one.
Representing Team GB, Kieran Riley!
Your current world champion and trying to break into the
your
podium for the overall.
Gold medalist representing Australian cycling, Logan Martin!
Olympic gold medalist.
Representing Team France, Anthony Jean-Jean!
Anthony currently sitting in that third place spot in the overall.
Riding for Team GB, Dylan Hesse!
Coming out of nowhere with that 37th spot, Dylan Hesse.
Number one qualifier, riding for Team USA Cycling, Nick Bruce.
Your bronze medalist from the World Championships
ladies
this year and currently sitting in 25th.
Make some noise, Bashop!
Wow. What an impressive lineup that we have.
I mean, look at the sun shining through those clouds, just setting the stage for this epic men's finals.
It has something holy to it.
Absolutely. Lord, shining on the creation. That's so rad. And these riders are ready. The fans are ready. They have been getting behind all the competing athletes this weekend.
Like we were witness to the semifinals yesterday. And wow, the action that was going on, that was insane. And that's how we got this starlist for the final. So we're going to have two heats. Number 1-6 heat 1. Number 7-12 heat 2.
And Daniel's going to be kicking it all off for us this afternoon.
And there's going to be a lot going on in this final. I mean, first, let's take a look at the leaderboard. We got Logan in first place, followed by Marcus and Anthony. But look at that difference. It's only a 40 points between the second and the third spot. And even Kieran is behind Anthony with just 60 points. So, like, a lot can shake up in that World Cup ranking.
As we just got to witness in the women's finals in that overall podium getting switched up. So we'll see what happens here in the men's finals.
Now let's take a look at the weather. It's sunny. We got 90 degrees Celsius out here. How much is that in Fahrenheit, Dustin?
Always hard to calculate that, but I will say it has been raining a lot. And then into the weekend, it has been beautiful weather for these athletes to be able to compete in. So that has been a blessing as we get ready to start this all off.
So looking back at heat number one, we have Daniel Sandoval, Daniel Dares, Rimu Nakamura, Marin Rantes, Gustavo Oliveira, and Brian Fox. That's a worldwide lineup right there.
Some of the best riders in the world.
Taking you from the US to Brazil to Croatia, Venezuela. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Egon and I'll be your flight attendant on this finale.
All right, here we go again. I said Daniel Sandoval is going to get this all started off for us, and watching him warm up, he is flying high. And we are going to see some heavy combos out of him, doing it for the USA.
Like, he got very lucky in that semifinal qualifying, barely making that 12 spot, and now he's here, and he's going to show us what he's got.
He is not going to hold back. We are going to see some top-notch riding, getting the go-ahead when he's ready to go. This is going to get started. Let's go! All right, dropping in, coming straight into a transfer from the spine into the box with that downside to bar spin in the 360, and check out the height as he transfers across into that Mies carbine. Flared double tail whip. Wow, Daniel. Like I said, not holding back. Double tail whip coming back across the course into that Hurricane Parks bank.
Heading for that step up. That went so fast. That was a... Like, I don't even understand what happened there. That was a Superman C-grab 360.
But just like, dipping it down.
Yeah, nose heavy.
That is one of my favorite tricks to watch him do. But right there, you saw instead of continuing to keep his run going, he pulled it off to the side. Again, he wants to put the entire run together because he knows that it is your best run that counts. And so he doesn't need both of them. He just needs one. And so he's going to come back. Look at that height.
Replay. Yeah, like he was speeding. Like he was getting speed tickets all over the course. And then
one,
there's that
two. Catching it and finishing that rotation.
And there
wow,
we have
Daniel.
That.
Like, yeah, let's see what happened.
Almost inverting. I think he slipped the pedals.
He had them on, but they were just a little bit forward on the pedals. So as he made contact with the ground, it bumped the feet off the pedals. His first score coming in 41.8. So again, that's going to be his throwaway run. It's all going to come down to his second run.
Now, next up is a feast legend from Venezuela, Daniel Darce. Just a couple, just an hour ago, he was still coaching the Chinese women's team, and now he's here in the finals.
One of the most decorated athletes ever on a BMX bike. Let's see what Daniel brings to the course.
Like, he has the whole Chinese crowd cheering for him. Standing here to start in front of our announcing booth. Let's
get
it,
Daniel. Go ahead, and he's in. Yes, Daniel.
Oh, 720 Can-Can. That's a Daniel Darce classic. Flair, no-hander back into the course. Keeping it ripping around that doorway. Step it. Then time for the step. Oh!
What?
360 triple whip. Bringing the heat from Venezuela. Getting ready for that step up. And there we have the 720 no-hander.
Yes, Daniel. Putting it together. Alley-oop bar spin to follow it up. Carving across the course. Spinning that 360 X up, back into the box jump. Check this out, cash roll! Squeaking it around and keeping the run going strong. Tuck no hander on the Guangwu quarter pipe. Coming back over the box jump backwards. Where's he taking the speed? He's transferring from the spine into the TSG hit.
10 second buzzer.
Double tail whip, yes, Daniel. How's he gonna finish this run off? Transferring back, dipping it in that 360. Flare whip at the buzzer. Wow.
Such consistency, variety, and tricks.
His timing is incredible on that flare whip. True professional right there. That putting it down all the way to the last second.
That was 100% throughout his whole run.
Yeah, full on mixing it up, doing transfers across the course. Spin tricks, flip tricks, originality. The cash roll is a trick that he himself invented. Love seeing him pull that off in his run.
And that's how you win a silver medal in the Olympics. And with Paris coming up in the next summer, who knows, he might be there again. As one of the oldest riders here, there's that 720 stretched can-can like they do in Paris.
And look at this, one, two, three. Squeaks that third round, getting the speed. Yeah.
And then we had the 720 no-hander stretching those hands.
And look at this. That's the cash roll right there. And look at him coming in right at the top of that landing. Again, that's something that the judges are looking for, where you land on the ramps. And that transfer was awesome, getting that rotation at the last second.
Now we have that flare whip in front of the commentating booth. Like, he's standing right in front of us, and he's jumping to the first spot with 86.70.
That is a solid score to start it all off with, and you can see he is stoked on that.
I mean, not only he's stoked, like, everyone around here is stoked. Like, the energy here in China is as hot as a Szechuan pepper. Next up is going to be the 2022 world champion, from Japan. It's going to be Rimu Nakamura, five-time Japanese national champion, dropping and heading for the step up. What a 720 tail whip. Alley-oop tail whip down into the park. Going from landing to lip with that 360 can-can. Nice and high. Oh, landed a bit low coming back in, but he kept it going. Picking up that speed again. 360 tail whip. Ah, that's a small case that he has there. I think it threw him off a little bit. So this might be a throwaway run. He still has that second run. But nevertheless, a pretty strong start by Rimu Nakamura.
He was one of the still doing,
still going, like,
transferring 720 bar spin right there. So he's still working the course, finding that flow, making sure he can link all the lines together that he wants to, so that when he comes back in his second run, he's able to execute the tricks that he has in mind for all those different features.
You see this in a lot of contests. Like, if a rider, like, if something's off, they'll still try to ride as much as possible, like, to keep that body warm and to, like, feel how a line is jumping and take that into that second run, all that energy.
Well, because, yeah, when they're warming up, everyone's going every direction, so you don't have the course to yourself, so you want to take advantage of that when you can if the run is not going as you planned. But let's check out some of these highlights before he put it into cruise control. Huge 720 tail whip to start it all off right there. 360 can-can tire grab coming into the box jump lip, which is the difficult way to go as the transition is steeper, and so the precision has to be that much more. Right there, you see him hanging up just a little bit, and that might have been what threw him off on what he wanted to do, is hanging that back wheel up on the top of the box jump lip takes away some of that speed, which affects your flow and affects the ability to be able to perform the next trick you have in mind.
And there we have it, a 46.60 for Rimu Nakamura.
So from Rim, we are going to go to Marin Rentas, coming from Croatia.
Croatia, Hrvatska.
Again, very explosive rider.
Varazdin, it is Marin Rantes, current Croatian national champion and a 2018 World Cup winner that ended in Chengdu.
So many combinations. Very excited to see what he brings to the table as he starts off with a 720 bar spin. Yes, Marin. Double bar spin coming down onto that Hurricane Parks slant wall. Huge super Indy over the TSG hip. Bar spin to Tuckno Hander right in front of us. Whoa!
What?
Transferring 360 double tail whip to bar spin.
Triple tail whips. Martin keeps it going. Doing it for the country of Croatia. Doing it for the Hrvatska. 720 tail whip. Come on, Martin, keep it going, keep it going. Hitting that spine. Wow, 360 tail whip, throwing in a casual no-hander in there, setting up for that box again. Flip, double tail whip. Man, like the combination, he's pulling downside tail whip. I think that was even an opposite downside tail whip. Man, Martin is on fire.
And there you hear that 10-second buzzer going off as he continues to keep pushing through his run. Wall ride to Tuckno Hander. And that is going to be time for Marin. That double tail whip over the spine is going to be after the buzzer. But he's showing you he's still got gas in the tank after an incredible first run. The combos and doing them back to back. Wow.
Like you can see, he has been training at the Daniel Dares Action Sports Compound back in the USA. Like getting the fist bumps from them as well. See, like, we're all one big family. Look at him, like, so proud of his country. If you're watching from Croatia, if my Croatian is still like decent, I want to say Molim te. We love you, Croatia.
All right, let's check out some of these replays. Again, starting with that 720 bar spin. Dropping straight into it. And then right there, I love that Super C Indy over the TSG hip. That's one of the funnest feeling tricks you can do. And then look at this.
Oh, and a late bar spin in there. And that's taking a lot of risk, but Martin can pull this stuff off.
And to go straight from that into a triple tail whip at height, landing it clean.
I mean, he's going so fast. There's almost no time to line up again for that next trick. But since he's so consistent and he manages to land perfectly to the pedals, he can pull those things off.
Backflip double tail whip, AKA the helicopter. That bike is spinning over his head like a helicopter blade. Wow.
So we still got Daniel in first with that 86.70.
And you seeing some of his fun personality right there as the camera's pointed on him.
Like, have you taken a look at the helmet yet? That's all his family on there.
And there we go, cracking into the 90s with a 90.6. He is stoked on that. What a way to start it off.
So looking at the current ranking, he has got that 20th spot, and he might jump some spots after this Bajung stop here in China.
Now we're taking it to South America in the lovely country of Brazil, the high-flying Gustavo Oliveira. Look at him. Double tire grab to tuck, no hander at height, stepping back into that Bajung quarter. Double bar spin transferring from spine. Whoa, going over that quarter extension with a double tail whip. Tuck no hander over the volcano. Look back on that Hurricane Park's bank wall. 360 tail whip to bar spin. Gustavo going in right now.
Gustavo doing a samba on the course. Yes, one-footed X up. Nice toboggan getting in the back seat. Flip whip combining the backflip and that tail whip. Oh, nice and flat tabletop going really high on that one. No hander going back to the, oh yes. Come on, Gustavo, tail whip the spine. Keep in mind, it's a very mellow spine that he was jumping. Wall ride, pulling back into the park. That was a 10 second timer that you just heard. No hander, 5 seconds on the clock. Flare bar spin. And a truck driver tiny whip just before the buzzer.
Wow, Gustavo. Definitely checking the height meter box for the judges. Roasting all around this course. The pop that Gustavo has when he hits the top of the transition is such a treat to watch.
There must be something in the water in Brazil. I mean, like, he's bringing that heat.
And I love the way he mixes big combo tricks, and then you see him getting super stylish. That tabletop just holding it, locking it in. Let's check out some of these replays.
He's bringing like a whole new kind of style. You see, like, we have the double tire grab to no hander. Not a lot of guys are doing that. Then we got the bar spin to can-can. Look at the stretch on that one. And then heel. Yeah, that double tail whip.
Transferring all the way over that extended quarter right
catching
there.
Catching the pedals, I mean, that's like the execution you're looking for to impress those judges. Yeah, 360 tail whip to bar spin. Then there we had that flip whip.
Yeah, and you see him just going straight to pedals. That is the execution that the judges are looking for in these. And then again, throwing this flare bar at the end of his run. That is a trick that takes a lot of strength and exertion, and he's doing that at the end when he has used that entire minute. That is awesome right there. Getting some knuckles, getting some stoke from his fellow Brazilian teammate. And score coming in for Gustavo, 82.4. All right, solid run under his belt. He's got him in third place right now, and he knows what he can do as he comes back for that second run as he wants to keep climbing that leaderboard.
And now the rider who's making me very thirsty, that is Brian Fox. I wonder why I'm thirsty. It might be the aura that he's sending out to every all of you out there. Brian Fox, he has been stomping. He's been abusing the ramps here in China.
Yeah, he was incredible in semifinals and very excited to see him throw this run together. Starting off with a tuck no-hander as he transfers into that Hurricane Park. Whoa! Backflip! Double bar spin into a flare bar spin. Charging the transfer from the box, landing into the TSG hip, and then flared downside whip at height.
That was huge. 720 bar spin. He keeps it cracking. Nice and high tail whip. Getting back to that jump box. Oh, Suey no-hander. Letting go of those bars, kicking them back. Double backflip!
Two times around, let's go, Brian! Keeping that momentum going as he's just over halfway through his run. Look at this, coming at the Powered by Fees quarter. Huge flare turn down right there as he spins into the box landing. Coming at the Guangwu quarter, downside tail whip. Come on, Brian!
10-second buzzer, and he's making it look effortless. Lining up for that jump box again. What does he have? 780!
End of the run.
I mean, there's so much stuff going on in a 10-8. There's so much speed. You have to nail that landing. I think he's all right. He's a bit bummed out. But I think
so much momentum as he's spinning around three times.
I think it's okay. Like, he went down hard. I hope the ramp's okay.
Wow, Brian. All right, and he's back up to his feet. We are glad to see that.
So that was Brian's tube that just exploded. As we said, he is a heavy hitter. So let's take a look at that replay, starting off with the backflip bar spin, reverting the bar spin the other way around. Then here in front of the commentator booth, that's the flare downside tail whip. Keeping it going. Oh, look at that, hucking that double backflip, nailing the landing. Like, all the force that's going into these ramps and into his bikes.
The clicking of that trail, like, he had that fully extended in the turn down, going over 180 degrees as he turns those handlebars.
And there we have that 1080, so that's 1, 2, 3 rotations. And look at that landing, I think. A little bit under-rotated.
I'm so thankful he got those hands under his body to keep his face from hitting the ground right there, as that was a heavy slam. Again, they're gonna have about 6 minutes to fix that front wheel before he has to do his second run. Score coming in, 66.6. So he's gonna have to come back in that second run. Everything's gonna be on the line in it, but he is not afraid of that pressure. He handles it so good, but right now we're gonna take it back over to Daniel Sandoval.
Daniel Sandoval for Team USA. Had a bit of a slip up in that first heat and first run in this heat with the 41.80. And he wants to compensate for that. He wants to go off of some spots in the ranking. Oh!
And check this out, going over that UCI wall. Look at the height as he transfers into the Powered by Fees corner. Whoa! No way! Flair triple tail whip! Daniel Sandoval!
What just happened?
No!
Holy
the crowd
smokes.
Giving him some love. All the riders, everybody here is going wild. That flare triple tail whip was absolutely crazy.
The bike just couldn't take it anymore. Wow, he was going so fast, so high. Flare triple whip. Wow, yeah. That's the only thing that we can say.
Who knows where that run was gonna go from there? That was unreal. I cannot wait to see the replay on this.
I think the world is not ready for Daniel Sandoval's run.
Wow.
That's the Arizona heat.
All right, let's watch this replay.
So that's a 360 bar spin to downside tail whip.
Transferring from the spine to the box landing right there.
See, like, he keeps pedaling, like, he keeps building that speed, like, pushing down hard, coming back into that wall ride. And then, see, going high, spotting that landing nice and high, and then full speed ahead. Flare, 1, 2, three tail whips. But you can see, like, his tire moving, I think. That caused him.
And everyone is going wild as they watch that replay here. That is one of the most crazy tricks I've ever seen go down.
I'm glad he walked away from that one. Still a very solid season so far. He got that 15th spot in the world ranking, so he's definitely going to get some points in the UCI point ranking and the national ranking as well. And that takes us back to Daniel Ders, the man, the Fees legend.
He laced his first run, but we know he wants to build on that and get himself up into that top spot. And so he's getting that eye of the tiger. He's getting himself focused, visualizing his run, how he wants to implement all those tricks and all the different features on this Hurricane Parks course. Let's go, Daniel. All right, he's got the go-ahead. The stoke is built. And Daniel Ders coming in.
Dropping in, getting full speed DNS bind. 720, no-hander. Oh, Flair no-hander, taking the hands off. Roasting his way across that doorway, ready for that jump box. 360 triple tail whip. Nice and clean bar spin, ready to hit that feast curve wall again. Heading into the, barely making it back into set. Oh, 720.
That was crazy. Alley-oop bar spin coming back down into the box jump hip, into the lip of it, out of the top of that curved vert wall, into his cash roll. Let's go, Daniel. Keep this momentum going. Classic Daniel Dares. No foot kink-in whip. Spinning over the box jump backwards, keeping his flow going into that final 10 seconds, transferring from the spine to the TSG hip.
Keep it going, lining up once more for one of the obstacles. 360. And then in front of the commentator booth, that flare whip. Hitting the barriers on his way back in. Oh, gracias, Daniel. Getting all the love from the crowd. Getting all the love from you at home. All of you watching all over the world. Wow. I really hope we get to see him at the Olympics in Paris again, seeing him at the Place de la Concorde.
I do too. I always love the energy he brings to the course. That huge 270 from the Powered by Feast quarter into that Hurricane Park slant wall, the transition of that is very difficult. You see a lot of straight tricks. I have not seen anyone else doing a rotating trick on that. That was, look at that. As we look at the replays, that 720 can one-hander.
And then the flare, no-hander, stretching those hands. Nice execution by Daniel. Pumping his way through that volcano setup. And then the 360, 1-2, triple whip.
That's wow, like a, Daniel. And this is the spin that I was talking about.
And that was a close call as well. Like, he was almost scraping that bank. Like, we've seen riders struggle on a regular hip, and he just does a 270 over it. Wow.
Love this alley-ooping 360 double tail whip transfer.
And there we had it. That was the flare whip, but on his way back in, almost crashing into the UCI barrier. Oh, almost ripping it.
And we'll have to see. I think that was after the buzzer. And so I think with the little slip up, I don't think that will affect his score on that from what the judges are watching, because your tires need to be completely parallel with the ground before that buzzer goes off for that trick to count, whether it helps your score or takes away from your score. So either case. So that's what the judges are looking for, as that buzzer goes off. And right here, score coming in, it's an 82.8, so it is not going to improve on his first run score, but he is currently sitting in second place.
And then from Venezuela all the way to Japan to the 2022 world champion, five times Japanese national champion, fifth place at the Olympics, and also the fifth place in the current ranking. So let's see what Rimu Nakamura has up for us. The 720 tail whip.
To kick it off, straight into an alley-oop flare bar spin. Yes, Rim.
360 can-can, doing it like they do in Paris. Getting nice and high, lining up for that box jump. Backflip, double bar spin.
I think he might have thrown it three times.
We'll have to see on the replay, but he keeps it going. Oh! 360 windshield wiper. He cased it on the quarter here. Oh, I think he, like, something's off on the bike.
Yeah, he's looking at his sprocket after he did that 360 windshield wiper, or 360 tail whip to downside whip. You saw him coming. He was a little off of his line and hung up on.
Oh, yeah. It looks like his sprocket is crooked.
Yeah, he hung up right on this Bajun quarter, and it is very steep. So I think he went straight to the sprocket right there, bending it.
That was a literal disaster. So if you're not familiar with BMX tricks, a disaster is when you do a 180 and have your front wheel in the quarter and your back wheel on top of the deck. It's not a trick you expect
And let's watch some of these highlights. That was a crazy run until that
one,
last one. Two.
That was a triple bar spin flip.
Man, these riders are doing their combinations so quick. It is hard to stay on top of it. But look at the height he had on that bar spin to tuck no-hander. And then let's watch what happened here.
So that's the 360 tilt-up, the downside whip. We call that a windshield wiper, going from one whip to the other. And then, oh, man, like, look how he bent his sprocket. Well, no worries. His dad has a bike shop. He's a mechanic. He's even the Team Japan mechanic.
It's heartbreaking. I really wanted to see him keep going with that run. But again, we're glad that he's safe, walking out in his own strength. And with that, we are going to take it over to Croatia's Marin Rantes. Again, currently in that top spot as he had an unreal first run. Let's see what he brings to us in this second run.
Come on, Martin, you got this. Dropping in, going full speed for that step up. 720 bar spin. And then bar spinning his way down into the park. Ooh, almost steering his way back in. Yeah, the Superman Indy style, kicking those legs out. Bar spin to no-hander. And then that transfer, 360 double tail up to bar spin.
Wow, straight into a triple tail whip. Look at him linking these tricks back to back, carving around that curve wall into the box jump. 720 tail whip. Yes, man, keeping it going, carving over that UCI wall. Look at this transfer from the spine into the box flip with a 360 whip to tuck no-hander.
What? Backflip doubling on that tail whip. There we have that downside whip. Still has some time left, as we're gonna hear that 10-second buzzer coming in. Front flip!
No way!
What? Come on, keep it going, last seconds. Yeah, with the wall right to no-hander. Just out of time.
Wow, I was not expecting
the front
that flail.
That happened right in front of us. Like, we could feel the wind coming from his bike as he threw that around.
The risk factor on that, especially on this quarter pipe right here, it is so steep. It goes into a curve, so there's all these different elements that he's got to take into account as he does that.
It's like a small pocket that we have here, and like, he turns to the left, so he was heading towards that pocket. Insane riding by Mari Nantes. He still has that top spot right now at 90.60. Will he improve? I think that front flare, that must have impressed the judging panel.
Yeah, he upped the difficulty on his tricks, fully extending the ones that he did. Look at this. One, two. As he comes around,
another bar spin.
Wow. And then I love how he goes straight from that crazy combo into this triple tail whip air. And again, landing that solid, keeping his flow going.
And that's the 720 tail whip, starting with that 360 tail whip and then into the other 360. A total of 720. And then here we have that 360 tail whip into a no-hander. Getting it nice and clean and stretch out there. Backflip, double tail whip, man.
So we're seeing him do 360 combinations, backflip combinations, look at this.
That's a front flare. Like, dude, like landing those wheels at the same time. Oh, man.
And there is 92.2, improving his score even further, solidifying himself in that first place spot.
Like, Martin has this kind of connection with China. I mean, in 2018, he took the World Cup that ended in Chengdu, not too far from here. Like, maybe history is going to repeat himself. Maybe he's going to take another win here in China. But first, let's get that samba music playing. Let's get back to Brazil with Gustavo Oliveira.
The high-flying Brazilian coming in. Look at this height he starts off with. Double tire grab to tuck no-hander, full extension. I love this setback that he does. Bar spin, and then look at this. Whoa! 360 triple bar spin into a double tail whip transfer over that quarter extension. Massive knack-knack,
coming
Gustavo.
With that heat. Ready for that step up, 360 tail up to bar spin. Nice L-U-P, triple bar spin.
Yeah.
My God, this man keeps spinning and flipping and whipping.
Massive air out of that curve wall.
Oh.
What, into the flip whip? Come on, Gustavo. Whoa!
absolutely boosting on that tabletop.
Textbook.
Even almost inverting that table. Oh, yeah, with the XF2 turn on. That's a neat combo right there. Double tail up on that mellow street spine. 10-second buzzer as we head into those last seconds of Gustavo Oliveira from Brazil. Nice flare, and then maybe a last truck driver. Like, I loved it. I love how the DJ started playing that samba music as well. I mean, that unlocked something inside Gustavo.
Gustavo turning it up in run number two, taking his height even higher, building on the different tricks, getting the stoke. I love it. These juniors and amateurs that were competing earlier today are insane, and I love the stoke. Gustavo's been hanging with them over in the training side of this Hurricane Parks course, and they're giving him that love right here.
Like, he's transferring that Brazilian heat to the Chinese people. They want to do that samba on the bike as well, you know? So right now, he still has that third spot, finishing as the fifth in this heat. 82.40. Second spot, Daniel Dares at 86.70. And Stronghold, oh, let's look at that replay first. The bar spin. Oh, look at
the
that.
The can-can as he steps back into that Bajun quarter right there.
360, one, two, three. Was that four bar spins? That's a backflip, sail whip. And like, he's mixing all these tricks. We're seeing these more kind of mid-school tricks like the X-ups and the turn wash.
Textbook.
Oh, I see, like, going even over that, like, 90 degrees that you want to have in that tabletop. So in a tabletop, you want to get your bike as flat as possible. But if you want to do even better, try to invert it, get it over that 90 degree. 84.80, securing that third spot in the standings right now. So that brings us to the last rider of this first heat. Stay around because we still got that second heat, but right now we're gonna have Brian Fox. Bailed on a 1080 in the first run, so he's out here to get his revenge.
Out here on a mission, and you see that focus in his eyes as he's ready to go on run number two. Come on, Brian. Drop it in. Coming at this box jump backwards. Tuck no hander into the Power by Feast quarter. Hipping into the step up box. Look at this. Backflip, bar spin to bar spin back into a flare bar spin. Huge links right here as he transfers all the way across into that TSG.
Oh.
And flare downside tail whip at height into a transferring 720 bar spin.
But the heat that he's bringing to this course, Brian Fox keeps it going. Going nice and high over that box again. Getting ready for a double backflip.
Oh!
He looped out on that double backflip. Like, he came in so hot, the course couldn't handle it. Oh, man. I mean, it was like the same thing going on with Daniel. Like, they're just too good for this course.
Wow.
So let's take a look at what happened. First, we started with that backflip bar spin and then reverting that bar spin the other way around. Then flaring down into the bank, putting an extra bar spin in there as well. And then here in front of us,
look at the height on this flare downside tail whip. And then look at where he lands on the quarter, right at the top of the quarter. That is something that the judges are definitely looking at. And then I love how he is transferring from the spine to the box jump with that 720 bar spin.
Absolutely, he's weaked him. That's a double backflip. And let's see, as he's coming in, as he's landing, like, he's slipping out on that one.
He's just a little off access, it looked like, and had him on the side and just barely slipping out on that. Brian is so good at those double backflips, but just barely missing it right here.
I mean, just the sheer force as you land the bike into a jump box, I mean, that's one. But coming in from a double backflip, like, there's so much speed, so much momentum coming in, and that's going to be 66. We're going to hold 66.6 for Brian. So that's the end of the first heat here. We've seen some amazing stuff, so we're getting ready for the highlights of this first heat. Stay around. Welcome back for the second heat at this UCI BMX Freestyle World Cup stop. We're going to take a look at the standings. After heat number one, we have Martin Rantes leading the pack with 92.2, followed by Daniel Dares in second, and the Brazilian Gustavo Oliveira with the 84.80. But we still have six riders coming up.
And these are your top qualifiers from the semifinals. They were absolutely shredding in that, so you know they're going to be bringing it all. So let's take a look at our Heat 2 riders.
So we have Marcus Christopher from the USA, world champion Kieran Riley, Olympic gold medalist Logan Martin, Anthony Jean-Jean from France, Dylan Hesse coming out of nowhere at this competition, and then the top finalist from yesterday, that is Nick Bruce. So first rider is going to be Marcus Christopher, and he has had a great season so far. Currently second in the ranking, taking top spots at the other locations. So currently in that second spot with 2,110 points, but we still have that 1,000 points for the first place here today in Bajung, China. Marcus Christopher getting ready to drop in.
And here we go, Marcus coming in, charging across the course to blast from that snowplow into the Hurricane Park's bank wall. Wow, 720. Look back on that step up into a flare downside tail whip, coming back over the box jump with a 360 bar spin way out of the top of the curve vert wall into a backflip. Oh, bar spin to tail whip.
Oh, man.
Wow, he's back up on his own strength.
That was already a crazy solid run. Wow. Like he walked away from that crash.
That is a gnarly trick to walk away from right there. So much going on in it, but Marcus back up to the top. In the semifinals yesterday, we saw him struggle on his first and then come in clutch in run number two when it counted to get him into finals. So let's see if he can do that same thing and get himself up onto that podium.
This is the comeback man with that 720 look back. Then heading back to the course with that flare downside tail whip.
And so when you hear us say downside, he is kicking the bike down towards the ground.
And that was a backflip bar spin to downside tail whip. Extra hard. But no worries, he still has that second run. And as we said in semifinals, this happened too. Crashing into that first run and then getting that redemption on that second run and qualifying into that seventh spot here in this final, 37.80. Then we got our next rider, currently in the fourth spot, sporting that world champion jersey from Gateshead, United Kingdom, Kieran Riley.
Let's go, Kieran, coming at this step-up box jump, starting it off with a front flip, look like a no-hander, into a 540 bar spin as he comes into the box jump hip. 360 bar spin to tabletop, flying out of the top of the curve, vert wall into a 720 tail whip. Huge air, getting a double tail whip on that Guan-Wu quarter pipe, transferring from the spine into the TSG hip with an extended tuck no-hander flare bar spin at height as he transfers from the spine into the box lane with a 360 double tail whip.
And we're halfway Kieran's first run. That is a double tail whip air, getting ready for that box jump again. See as he makes his way through with the flare tail whip. 360 double bar spin, triple bar spin, roasting that wall ride. He's getting ready to do some other massive trick, and that is the double flare! Oh! That is a Kieran Riley signature trick. It is, he has this one unlocked. Something must have happened there while he was spinning, but don't worry, he still has that second run. And not only is he really good at double flares, he was the first rider to actually land a triple flare. First rider in the world to do that. That was an 8-month project to land that one. So let's see the replays. We got that Nice.
Yeah, he tucked those bars in. It looks like he wants to throw those hands off in that front flip that he's starting with. And then right there into a 540 flare coming down into that Hurricane Park's bank wall. And then check this out. 720 tail whip. Wow, Kieran. And then straight into a double tail whip at height.
Catching
he's putting huge combos back to back to back.
Now we have that 360 double tail whip. Looks like he wanted to throw in an extra bar spin. Not sure, but who knows. Now we have that flare whip. Catching the paddles perfectly, coming back in. Then here he is. He's picking up that speed for that double flare because you need a lot of speed, a lot of height. Starts the turn, that's one, that's two flips. But as he comes back in, I think like he under-rotated it just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
He needed just like that bit more speed to go a bit higher to get an rotation a bit quicker as well. But still, solid run, putting him in that fifth spot in the current ranking at this event. Now next up is one of the most consistent riders this season. It's your Australian gold Olympic medalist, Logan Martin. Let's see at the highlights from this season.
Wow, number two. Let's make some noise for Logan Martin!
Oh my gosh, opposite flare whip, that was awesome! Oh wow, flip grip coming down the step down. Two, one, Logan Martin!
So that's a win in Saudi Arabia, a win in France. A podium spot in Brussels. There is one thing we can tell you already. Mathematically, he is your World Cup champion. But let's see what he can do here in China. Oh!
Wow.
360, nice and effort. Coming back into the park with the 360 bar spin. Getting nice and high on that piece. Curve wall, ready for the box with the 720 no-hander.
Yes, Logan, look at that. Transferring into that other quarter with the double bar spin and then transferring 360 tail whip to bar spin. Catch and transition perfect as he comes back. 720 tail whip, keeping it going, Logan.
Double downside tail whip, even pushed it with the opposite foot. Quick no-hander going for the big flare right in front of our commentator booth. Oh, triple opposite tail whip. Like triples is impressive already, but doing it with the opposite foot even harder. No-hander coming back at that step up.
Barrel last ball, seconds. Bar spin into it, and then let's see it at the end. What?
Flipping the step down.
The step down right before the buzzer goes off. That was timed absolutely perfect.
I'm going to need a doctor after this run.
Giving a shout out to his son, Noah. No, his wife, Kim, his son, Noah, and his daughter, Luna, are cheering him on at home, and he's giving that love right back to him.
Let's take a look at that replay, and when, what a run that was. So we have that 360 invert. He's dipping it so heavy
awesome.
On that free, almost like he flipped it, and then we have that flare. Downside tail up, and here we have that 720 no-hander. And look at the pedal, like at his foot placement and a whip. So here we have a 360 tail whip to bar spin. And he had to pull in back on that lip.
Yeah, catching that transition perfect so he could generate the speed for that 720 tail whip.
And look at that, that's one, two, three whips. But he pushed that with his front foot, which makes it even harder compared to regular tail ups. And then here we had that flip whip. Oh, going the other way around on that step up.
And what a way to cap off the run. That landing is completely blind, and he landed absolutely perfect.
And the timing was like sublime, like everything under a minute.
Wow, that was a treat of a run right there. And score coming in,
94.1.
Logan Martin. That top spot.
Is he going to take three wins in the World Cup ranking? But now we got Anthony Zhaozhao. He also has that third spot right now. also very consistent, winning in Brussels. Let's take a look at his season. Now we already know that Logan's gonna take like the global classification, but he still have a battle going on between Anthony Jean-Jean from France and Marcus Tristram from the USA. There's only a 40-point difference between the two riders. So I'm really curious what he's gonna do now. He took the win at the last stop in Brussels, second in Montpellier, 18th spot in Saudi Arabia. Let's look what the Frenchie has for us. Starting off with the 720 power spin. Oh, alley-oop flare making its way to the jump box. Double tail whip going high on that wall.
Wow, backflip, triple tail whip. Anthony is on it right now. Straight into a flare, double tail whip. Anthony Jean-Jean on top of it right now. Into a double
backflip,
landing absolutely perfect on that, into a super indie, transferring over that quarter pipe, flying into this. Look at this line as he comes back across the course at the TSG hip, into a double tail whip, coming at the UCI wall, carving over the top, full speed ahead as he transfers from the landing into the TSG hip, transferring over.
Going side to side, 10 second timer, keep it going, Anthony, allez Anthony! He's the French chouchou. And that, 720 to spine. Oh, man.
And look at the stoke as he pulled off.
He wants to represent France next summer in Paris. He wants to rip that course on Place de la Concorde, the venue for the 2024 Olympics for freestyle BMX.
What a dialed run right there. The tricks that he was linking together.
I mean, the pressure's on for that podium battle. Still, a lot can happen, as we said, between him and Marcus Christopher. That's a 720 bar spin that we have right there. And then that's 1, 2 tail whips. Nice catch, back into the lip of the jump box. And then lining up to the jump box again, and then he hits us with that 1, 2, triple whip backflip.
And he went straight from that into a double whip flare. But right here, double backflip, and right at the top, you couldn't have asked for a cleaner landing on that double backflip.
There we have that double tail whip, and landing nice and high, conserving all that speed. Getting ready for that wall ride. And then here we have that side-to-side transfer, double tail whip, lining up for the quarter here in front of the announcer booth with the flared downside tail whip.
He is such a high-energy rider, linking it back-to-back, and then the 720 over the spine. Again, did you see where his tire landed? Right at the top of it.
So he needs a 94.10 to beat Logan Martin's score. And we're checking our screen as well, because we have like the full leaderboard. And with Marcus Christopher's ninth place right now, and this score coming in, 95!
Wow.
Mathematically, he is claiming that second spot from Marcus. Wow. Wow,
just he came out swinging and kept it going all the way to the end, and the judges rewarding him with that 95.
Our next rider from the UK, that is going to be Dylan Hassey.
He has been on it lately, and he's showing you why as he drops in right here for his first one. Backflip! Four bar spins.
Quadruple bar spin, and he keeps it going.
Dylan.
Truck driver, which is a bar spin 360. Oh, with the Man, like his flip bar spin combination, that was another double bar spin backflip that he did. Dylan Hasse for Team Great Britain. Losing a bit of speed here. I think something might be off on his bike, maybe. Something not feeling too well. So he's just going to cruise out his run. Feel the ramps. Memorize the run that he has in mind. Because this is only his first run. And as we said, the best run will count.
Yeah, we're going to have to see what happened in the replays, hopefully, on why he took the foot off the gas at the end of that first run.
Like, sometimes even we, as announcers or the judges, can't really tell what went wrong. It might be something that fell off while he was riding, as he was pumping down the ramp.
Watch this first one, though. One, two,
three, four bar spins.
That is a five-trick combo going down right there to start his run off.
Another backflip, double bar spin. I mean, he is spinning and twisting in every way possible. Like behind him, that's Greg Illingworth, one of the coaches for Team Great Britain. I mean, everything went pretty well. He got to finish his run. He felt the ramps. He knows what to take care of. We're getting a lot of wasps around here as well, because I see like the riders and the judges swatting away the wasps as they infest the course. And there we have the 38.34.
And all right, here we go to Nick Bruce, qualifying in that first place position, and now ready to throw down his first run, getting the stoke from the crowd. And Nick Bruce is in, doing it for the USA. Look at this start.
What?
Backflip windshield wiper into a tuck no hander as he comes over the box jump backwards with a 360 bar spin.
Oof. I think he missed his paddle on the way back in. What happened down there? I mean, this is only Nick, his first run. Let's see. Something's wrong with the bike.
Yeah, he's checking everything out, seeing what
looks
happened
okay
right there.
I mean, by the way he started this one, let's look at this. So we got the backflip, we got a regular tail up and kicking it back. So that's a windshield wiper into a backflip. And then let's see what happened here on the box. So we got the truck driver.
Oh, his foot was floating around.
Oh, like he missed his back pedal.
Yeah, as he was doing that 360 bar spin, he was adjusting his feet, trying to get it into the position that he wanted to go into the next hit, and looks like it just floated a little bit too high where he landed in the transition.
Now, instead of waiting for his points, he's just gonna keep cruising, feel how the bike is doing. The bike looks okay. And it feels okay for Nick as well. He's not gonna need any last minute repairs.
Nick, and he knows he's got that second run. He's no stranger to adversity. He is a warrior. He know he has what it takes to be able to come back and run number two and get himself up here. His score coming in 27.8. Obviously not what he's looking for. It's got him sitting in 12th place.
He's also a World Cup stop winner in China. In 2017, he won the last stop in Chengdu.
And he's your current bronze medalist in the World Championships that just happened in Glasgow, Scotland.
Don't worry, Nick, you still have that second run. And now the heat is on for Marcus. As we said, Anthony just jumped over Marcus, not only at this final, but also in the general classification. So let's see what he's got for us. Marcus Christopher dropping in, going full speed on the snowplow, no hander, time for that step up. 720 look back, going back into the park with the flare, downside tail whip, already going really well. Truck driver going high, ready for that jump box as he hits us with the backflip bar spin downside whip.
Yes, Marcus, wow, straight into a triple downside tail whip, and then right in front of us, flare bar spin to turn down into a transferring 720 from the spine to the box jump landing. Yes, Marcus, keep it going. Flare tuck no hander and into the DSG hip.
Keep it going. We're in the last 20 seconds of his run. He keeps his speed. Oh, 720, Noander. There's so much going on in this run. This man cannot be stopped. Flair turned down. X up, and we're in the last seconds. And with the flare. Oh, man. Ike's shaking his head. I don't think it's a run that he wanted, but still, he put on a great effort to show everyone what he has.
Pure craziness happening out there on the course. Marcus Christopher.
He needs to jump over Anthony if he wants to secure that second spot that he had.
Let's look at some of these replays. There was that 720 look back, and then here we go with the backflip, bar spin to tail whip. Landing clean, and then straight from that crazy trick into a triple downside tail whip. Again, you see him kicking that frame down towards the ground, and then here at height, flare bar spin to turn down.
Now we had that 720 transfer from the spine into the landing of the jump box. And here we have that 360 backflip, no hander, like,
yeah.
Like, sometimes it's going so fast, like, even we announcers need to see the replays to correct ourselves.
Yeah, give us some grace on that, because these riders are putting together heavy runs, linking all these tricks together.
And it's even a harder job for the judges, because they have to get the points in, and that's an 89 points for Marcus Christopher, bumping it up to that fourth place.
Again, he wanted to make it onto that podium, but still bumping himself into fourth place, which is an awesome improvement from where he was. And so with that, we are now taking it over to the UK's Kieran Riley.
Current world champion. Unfortunately slipped a bit on that double flare, but he's back. He wants to make that podium.
You saw him look at the camera and say, let's go. He's ready for this. And
front
there we
flip,
go.
No-hander.
Getting the full extension he was looking for, and then into a 540 bar spin, 360 bar spin to tabletop. Yes, Kieran, on it right now. What? 720 double tail whip. No way, Kieran.
Stretching
transferring
those
from
hands.
The spine into that TSG hip with a tug no hander.
Now we have 360 double tail whip to bar spin. Keep it going. That's a triple tail whip. Kieran is bringing the fire, and that's the flare tail whip. And now he's gonna build that speed again. Let's see, as he crosses that channel across the wall ride, jumps nice and high, ready for that double flare. And he stops it!
And he's into his final seconds. Come on, Kieran!
360 tail whip, quick little tabletop in there, and that's the buzzer.
Wow! That was so clutch, putting it down when it mattered most, Kieran Riley.
World champion? I mean, this is out of this world.
Yeah, showing why he has that current world champion jersey on, nailing that double flare.
The man from Gateshead, the British Bull, doing it for Toller. I think Sebastian keeps watching as well, and he's proud. And that's Jamie Bestwick, another one of the coaches from Team Great Britain. And, I think Team Great Britain's going to have a party, regardless of the outcome of this event.
I mean, that was the run that he was looking for. You didn't see the extension on that first front flip, tuck no hander, but in run number two, it was fully stretched. Then look at these combos. Again, great course use, transferring around the course, massive tricks.
Going side to side, using every inch of this course. And that's the 360 double tail up to bar spin. Like, all these technical combinations that he's pulling. And here we have that 1, 2, 3 triple tail whip. And I hope we get to see that double flare again. Like, as you can see, that's not one, but two rotations coming back into the ramp.
Wow. Oh. He made sure to get the rotation that time, and whoa,
look at this. 1, 2, Like he pulls like two flips, then he pulls back in on that 180 to finish that double flare. So we're gonna look at that top score, which Anthony Jean-Jean is still holding.
Oh man.
The suspense right now as we wait the score from the judges.
And also really consistent season. A ninth place in Saudi Arabia, fifth in Montpellier, and a fourth spot. Can he make the podium this time?
And I love it. Both these guys having fun with each other right here. We got the split screen, and here we go.
96.56.
Bumping him into that top spot. Yes, Kieran.
This is going to change things up in the general ranking as well.
And the crowd going crazy for him. The riders, and look at that camaraderie right there. This is what I love about BMX, is the way that all these riders are cheering each other on. They want to see them get that run that they have planned out, and there is a prime example of it.
I just did a calculation, and with that result, Kieran is going to jump over Anthony, getting him that second spot in the general world ranking. Oh my God, like there's so much happening right now. We have Logan Martin dropping in, already securing that gold medal in general classification, holding that third spot right now.
But you know he wants to bump it up to the first, and he is putting the tricks together to try and make that happen as we go into that 720 tail whip. Yes, Logan, into a triple bar spin, transferring from quarter pipe to quarter pipe, and right there going from the spine into the box lip. Come on, Logan, keep it rolling.
720 bar spin catch, bar spin, so that's two bar spins and a 720. Double downside tail, pushing it with the opposite foot. No hander, whoa, coming in hot. Whoa, beautiful flare bar spin. What? What?
From the spine to the box, the forward bike flip. Yes, Logan, taking it up another level.
What a madman, oh, flipping bar spin.
And look at this timing right now, coming in with the flip tail whip over that in time. And that was the run he wanted to do. And look at this. Straight into
man.
It. Yes.
What just happened?
The stoke is unreal right now as these riders are backing each other up. They see the one get their run. They're like, all right, I want to get my run. They're going. Fueling off of each other.
This just in, there's another switch up in the general ranking. I mean, there might be, if he scores better than Kieran, according to the UCI points, then that's gonna be like, oh man, like, there's so many things going on the course, and we have to keep the general classification. Look at that 720 bar spin, catch bar spin.
So much going on in that. Just the force from the rotation, and then look at this bar spin flare at height right there.
And then he immediately went for that. I mean, look at that. He jumps that spine, throws his bike in front of him into a front flip.
That trick is already insane, just going straight, let alone transferring from that spine into the box jump lip.
Like, we've been seeing some crazy stuff happen in the last season, but I don't know what it is at this stop. Like, everyone is pushing the boundaries.
That was so legit. Wow.
Like, we got our eyes on the scoreboard. So in first, we still have Kieran Riley with that 96.56. Can Logan top that? Oh, man. Dustin, you're shaking. 96.74!
Look at how close those scores are as Logan goes into that top spot. Again, both of them giving props to one another. They came out, they both did the run that they had planned to the fullest, and they are just cheering each other on. But we are not done yet, ladies and gentlemen. We now turn our attention to Anthony Jean-Jean, currently sitting in third, but he wants to get himself back up to the top, and here we go.
Allez, Anthony, wait, BMX, 720 bar spin, double bar spin, Oh, alley-oop flaring it.
Alley-oop 540 flare straight into a double tail whip way out of the top of that curve vert wall. Backflip, triple tail whip.
Allez, 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 Anthony. Yes, flare, double tail whip. Keeps it going. No hander. Getting nice and high. Lining up for that jump box again. And there we have the double backflip. Halfway, Anthony's second run. Going indie style on that transfer. X up, getting high again. Over the snowplow. Back to the TSG hip.
I love that line that he takes to do that double whip over the TSG hip, and look at him carving over the UCI wall, coming all the way across coast to coast with that double whip into a flare downside tail whip into his final 10 seconds. Come on, Anthony. Up to the top of that UCI. Look at this.
One more quick route. 720. We hear the buzzer, but I'm not sure if he landed his wheels on the ground yet.
Wow, this is a legendary competition that we are getting to see unfold before our eyes.
That's a, like on the podium right now, there's only a 1.74 difference. Anthony has a last chance to shake things up. We still have Dylan Hesse and Igris coming up, so let's take a look at that replay. So that was a 720 bar spin catch, bar spin. Kept on pedaling. And then I think he was lining up for a big trick over the box jump. Was it that double backflip? Let's find out together. A backflip.
Triple tail whip. And look at the way he preloaded his body to get the pop he needed to be able to generate the motion of that triple tail whip. And then straight from that into a flare, a double tail whip.
Using all the muscle that he has. The Frenchie is going wild with the double backflip.
Coming in right at the top of that landing, keeping his speed going full force. And again, coast to coast right there from the box jump landing into that TSG hip over the spine. And again, linking tricks back to back as he goes straight from that coast to coast transfer into that flare downside tail whip. And that 720 right at the end of his run. Wow. And that alley-oop 540 flare that he did from the elevated portion of the course into that Hurricane Park's bank wall.
That was mental.
Ah, and score coming in, putting him into third place. 95.7, so improving on his first run score.
That was a very bon run, as a Frenchie would say. Très bien, très bien. Still, he's still on that podium.
And there we see a lot of our athletes cheering on our finalists here as we go to Dylan.
Dylan Hesse doing it for Team Great Britain. Something went off in that second round, but he's back. He's here for that redemption. Dropping in with the backflip. Quadruple barsman flipping those bars four times. Coming back into the skate park. 360 barspin. Oh, man. What? Backflip, double bar spin, two tail whip.
No way, and that's what he wanted in that first run that didn't happen, but then making it happen here in his second run. Come on, Dylan, keep this run happening.
Front flip. Come on, Dylan. Make the Great Britain proud, make Jamie proud. No hander coming back in. Nice and high, lining up, and that's a 360 bar spin to downside tail whip, flare tail whip.
Cutting across the course with that transfer from the spine into the TSG.
Double bar spin, come on, that's a 10 second buzzer. 360 tail whip, come on Dylan, you got this.
Alley-oop flare bar spin, 2-1. And that is gonna be time for Dylan. Wow. Coming back with authority in his second run. And now we see why he laid off the gas in the first, because that trick was insane. He did backflip, double bar spin to tail whip.
What an effort, what an effort. I mean, that's a combination we haven't seen yet this weekend. Like, that's bringing that unique style, that unique unique combination of tricks.
And let's watch these replays.
So that's one, two, Prix. Four
five
bars.
Trick combo.
We have that double bar spin backflip to tail whip. Oh man. And like he's so late with that tail whip, like he's really taking a risk there. Barely making it in time for the landing, but he made it, and then that front flip across the jump box.
Yeah, not your traditional transition to be able to do that front flip out of. Dylan really laying it down right there in his second run, and now anticipating those scores from the judges.
So if he wants to make podium.
Giving each other some thumbs up via the screen.
So he has to get a result of more than 95.70 to get to the podium, to knock Anthony off that podium. Our second to last rider that was qualified in second today, yesterday, in the semifinals. Team UK, Dylan Hesse. Like, we might have two Brits on a podium. And jumping to the sixth spot with an 87.70. Cheers to Dylan Hesse.
He's stoked, because that's going to bump him up in those overalls, especially as he keeps looking to 2024 in Paris. But right now, we turn our attention to USA's Nick Bruce coming out of Ohio. He is locked and loaded, ready to go. Nick dropping in for run number two, starting it off with a backflip, tail whip to tail whip back. Let's go, Nick. Straight into a flare, coming back across the course, 360 across the box jump backwards. Airing out of that curved vert wall, opposite 360 backflip. No way, spinning in his opposite direction in that.
Absolute.
Come on, Nick.
Legendary already in this run. Nick Bruce taking that hip, getting ready for that setup again. Yes, no hander backflip. Downside whipping back into the park. Hitting that hip with a nice stretched out no hander in front of us with the flare whip.
Wow.
Oh, that is impressive. 360 tail whip. Come on, Nick. He wants to improve. He's in the 12th place, the last spot right now. He's definitely gonna go up the ranks. 540 flare. We hear the 10 second buzzer. Double downside tail whip. And that's gonna be it for the American all the way from Ohio, Nick Bruce.
That was clutch to be able to throw down a massive run in run number two, as that first run did not go how he wanted. So him to be able to come out and put that down, incredible.
Now we have to take a look at the points. Because if Nick can't top Logan's points, that means Logan is gonna be this stop's winner with the 96.74.
I am in awe of what we're getting to see unfold before us in this World Cup stop, the final one of the year. But let's look at these replays.
That was a backflip, tail whip to opposite tail whip, or as we call it, a backflip windshield wipe. And that was the backflip opposite 360.
Full extension on that backflip tuck no hander. Right here at height with this flare tail whip. And watch where he lands on this quarter pipe. Right at the top in that prime spot. And then here we go. 540 flare, twisting around, getting the rotation he needed, holding on to that bike. Wow, Nick. Giving some love to the crowd.
He needs that 95.70 to make it to the podium. If not, it's gonna be Logan, Kieran, and Anthony. Look at them.
The split screen, looking at the two. So Nick trying to bump up into that first place position, which is currently being held by Logan Martin.
Like, just look at the leaderboard, 96.74. And that's 88.70 for Nick Bruce. And that means winner of the Bajong stop here in China is gonna be your Australian Olympic gold medalist, Logan Martin. Wow.
That was a legendary competition, and Logan put down an absolutely epic run. Again, giving a shout out to his family back at home, his son Noah, his wife Kim, and his daughter Luna. And he is stoked to come away with that first place position. See his mechanic Matt giving him some props.
He has podiumed at every stop, winning 3 out of 4 stops in this World Cup. That is... I can't even put it in words anymore. My brain is fried from seeing all these tricks being performed by the best riders in the world. So there we have it. That's the final result of this stop with Logan Martin in first, Kieran in second, and Anthony Jean-Jean taking the bronze medal at this stop
of the UCI BMX Freestyle World Cup, powered by Feast. Unreal.
Now we're gonna take a look at what happens in the ranking, if there's things that are shaken up.
And that first place here is, we already knew, but that even further solidifies his first place in the overall, coming in with 3,820 points.
We see Kieran jumping to that second spot, and Anthony ending with the bronze medal. But look how close they are. That's a 20-point difference between Kieran and Anthony. Wow.
We knew there could be some change-ups, and sure enough, it happened. It all came down to that final run of Kieran Riley.
Now, if you want to get involved in the Olympics as well, let's dive into the Olympics 3 Challenge. Now, this is a shout-out to every BMX rider out there, no matter your skill level. It's time to jump into that Olympic adventure. You just need to make a 30-second video and upload it to the Street Challenge website before the 22nd of October. Now hurry up, and then judges will give you the points to that video, and you can win an exclusive trip to the Shanghai Olympic qualifier event. Wow, like being part of an event like that. So
what
start
an opportunity.
Riding, start filming, and upload it to Olympic Street Challenge. And welcome back. We just took a look at some of the best, most pristine riding in the world. This event has been amazing, like the level of riding that we've seen, and not just the riding, but also like everything around us. We're in this luscious green Guanyu mountain region, and we want to thank everyone in China for being so like welcoming us with open arms, with all the hospitality that they have. We're getting ready for that podium ceremony. And it was a joy this week. And now we're gonna take a look back at Logan Martin's winning run.
This run was so clutch as he started it full throttle. And I look at the height that he went on that inverted 360, so amazing.
There we have him with that truck driver back into it. Getting all that speed for the jump box, and that's the 720 double tail whip. That is a very risky combination, and airing out with the double bar spin, 360 tail whip to late bar spin back in, back to that jump box. That's a 720 double bar spin.
Wow, Logan, and then into that opposite downside tail whip. Wow, Logan.
With the front foot, and then like right after this one, we have that.
Wow!
I still can't believe that happened.
He knew what was needed, and he threw it down right there. And again, the timing on his run. He knows it's the last 10 seconds. He wants to get these tricks in before that buzzer goes off. And look at this. Nobody else coming down the step down, and he does it with a backflip tail whip. Wow.
A front flip. I mean, like a front bike flip. Pulling that in a competition is high risk, but also high reward. And that got him that first spot, making him the winner of this final stop of the UCI BMX Freestyle World Cup. So we're gonna switch to the podium. Catfish, This is for you.
That was, without a doubt, the most intense BMX competition we have ever seen. A big thank you to the people here in Baojiang, China. That was incredible. Let's meet our podium finishers. Walking away in third place, representing France, Anthony Jean-Jean!
And since France is the host nation for the Olympics, he has a really good chance of riding for his country.
From Team GB, Kieran Riley!
Kieran Riley jumping to that second spot in overall as well.
Yeah, that was massive to be able to come in and make that happen.
And your champion of the final stop here at the UCI BMX Freestyle World Cup, Australia's Logan Martin!
Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi.
As Catfish said, that was definitely one of the most intense competitions we have ever gotten to witness, as they were just fueled by each other's runs, and the stoke was so high, the stage was set.
Like, I thought Brussels was total madness already, but these riders stepped up. I mean, it must have been the Szechuan Peppers. And this is a well-deserved podium. I mean, looking back at all these runs from these athletes, they deserve that spot on that podium.
Getting those Powered by Feast Panda Bears right there. Fun little souvenirs to be able to take home.
There we have the Chinese officials honoring our riders as well. And we want to thank Feast and Hurricane and the Chinese government for making this event possible, for building this venue, having this event over here in China.
The hospitality has been incredible.
So not only did they finish in these positions, but also the World Cup ends in this position as well, with Logan Martin taking that global ranking, followed by Kieran Riley in that second spot, and the bronze plate that goes to Anthony Jean-Jean. And now, after the photo ops, we're going to listen to what Logan has to say about this last stop, about his run, get that final comment in, and give him the honor of closing this last stop of the BMX Freestyle Park World Cup here in Baojiang.
These truly are some first-class competitors right here, and just having fun with the entire community out here in Baojiang, China.
Logan Martin, does it ever get old?
The feeling never gets old. I wanted to come and back this up again, you know, after winning the overall last year. I came into finals knowing I had secured the overall, but still wanted to put on a show and come out and do the best run I could do. And man, it was a battle out there. Kieran rode so good. Anthony topped it. It was just a battle, and I had to really go for it in that second run.
What motivates you at this point in your life? You've won pretty much every major BMX competition. What keeps you motivated to keep at this level?
More so now than ever, it's the challenge of beating the younger guys. I'm now, you know, I guess considered the old guy. I'm, almost entering my 30s. And yeah, it's a challenge. I enjoy challenges. I enjoy working hard to try and overcome some challenges. And yeah, I'm at home doing the best I can do, and I come to every event and do the best I can do.
It's awesome being here, and we've seen so many young kids. And all the young kids that I ask, they say, who's your favorite rider? You are everybody's favorite rider. What message do you have to all the kids worldwide that look up to you as their favorite rider?
Man, honestly, it's so epic to, you know, to know that there's lots of kids out there that you know, enjoy watching me ride and look up to me. And the younger kids here are absolutely insane, and the crowd has been crazy this whole week. You know, heaps of signatures from, you know, all the riders giving out all the signatures and heaps of photos. And yeah, to all those kids, keep pushing hard, keep grinding, and you'll get here one day. These kids in China are amazing, but it goes to anyone all over the world. If you guys work really hard, you can get to where you want to be.
Awesome. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, your champion, Australia's Logan Martin.
Yeah, Logan is such a stand-up guy. Love the encouragement he's given to viewers all around the world.
So I want to thank Feast once again and Hurricane. And Dustin, I want to thank you for helping me out on the commentating this weekend.
It has been such a blessing to join you in the booth, Aegon, and everything that we got to witness take place here.
All right. And I want to thank all of you watching this final stop. We had a blast, and we hope to see you at all the next contests. And hopefully, we're going to see you in Paris.
Yoo!